Welcome back to my channel. I'm Carolina. If you guys are new here, welcome to the family. And if you guys are returning subscribers, what up, fam? Woo, I'm so excited to see you guys. I'm so excited to bring you this new video. Honestly, I've been seeing so many videos like this, and I was really excited to create one. And I'm really excited to show you guys what I've come up with and what kind of theme I decided to do for this specific video, and also just for myself because I loved it. Oh my god, Zoe's crying. Come here, baby. But anyways, you guys, so as you guys might know, the iOS 14 update has dropped, and a lot of people have been talking about it. A lot of people have been editing their phones and making it all cute and aesthetic, and I just wanted to show you guys some tips and tricks that might help you guys with editing your home screen. Without further ado, let's just get started with the video. And you guys, while you guys are here, like this video if you guys like it, comment some ideas that you guys want to see in the future, videos and stuff like that, and subscribe. It would really help me out. Turn on your post notifications if you guys want to be informed to when I post a new video. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so you guys have to know about this new update that everyone's been talking about, and about the flexibility this update allows you to have with your iPhone. So we're gonna be talking about the iOS 14, because honestly, it's been super cool to recreate, you know, different things on your phone and just have the freedom of, you know, setting it up a way that you like your phone and the way you want it to look like every time you open your phone, which I think is great, honestly. So I'm just gonna show you guys a little bit of what my style, kind of what my aesthetic is. I have the iPhone 11 Max Pro, I believe. So it's the one with the three cameras. So I love this big phone, and it doesn't feel really big. But I do understand why people are like, oh, big phones are like too much work. Cause low-key kind of they are, cause sometimes they don't fit everywhere. So we're going to start. This is just a picture of my lock screen with Stella in Idaho. And boom, there we go. So this is the first page. So basically here I just have the aesthetic of what it is, and this is the second page as well. But let's start on the first page. So I decided to go with kind of a neutral tone theme for my phone. I loved the white and the, you know, cream gray colors. So here basically on the first page is what I have, is the apps that I mostly use. So for example, my camera, weather, photo, Gmail, Snap, TikTok, YouTube, and Instagram. And I'm going to show you how I made my home screen look like that. So as you can see here in the bottom, my Google page is just normal. So basically what I'm going to do is, once you get the picture of the apps icons that you do want to use, or the theme that you want for your phone, and then you guys, I'm just gonna go to shortcuts. So basically your iPhone should already have this. If not, you can go on the App Store and just download it. And you're gonna go here and press the little plus button, and where it says add action, you just are going to press there, and you're going to press where it says scripting. So once you are there, you're going to go to open app, and it's going to open up for you. It says new shortcut. You're going to press choose. And so here then it just displays all the apps that you have on your phone. So I'm going to go ahead and find the Google app. It's right there. Select that, and then you're going to go on to next. So then they'll give you like a place where you can put the shortcut name. You're going to put Google. So the way I'm setting up my titles are just that way because I just like the way it looks and like the aesthetic of it. But yeah, you're just going to go to done, and then you are going to go and see that it added to all the shortcuts. And you're gonna go ahead and press the three little dots again, and it's gonna say add to home screen. You're going to add to home screen, and it says choose photo. So you go to your photos and you pick on the app icon that you have selected, choose, add, done, and period. It has been added to your home screen. So now you leave there, you see it right there, and you're just gonna take this, press on it, and you're just gonna press remove app, but you're gonna move it to the app library. So don't make the mistake of deleting the app, because then it will get deleted. Press the Google and drag it there, and done. Okay, now that you have it on your screen, the only thing with this change with applying the app icon to the apps is that when you open it, it goes to the shortcuts and then it opens up the original app. I personally am not that fazed by it, but I know some people can be. So next I'm gonna show you how to get like the widgets and all that type of stuff, so that you have like these cute little like pictures and like times and like calendars on your screen and stuff like that. Basically, you have to download the app called Widgetsmith in order to put like these cute little stuff on your screen. So for an example, I'm gonna show you guys. So I have Widgetsmith downloaded, And here it just shows you basically everything that you can do. So you have medium wedges, small wedges, and large wedges. Let's just do, for an example, like a small wedge. So I'm gonna go add a small wedge, number 5, and then you press on it. And then here it gives you the option, like you can do a clock, you can do like month, date, whatever you want, custom, it doesn't matter. So I'm gonna go, let's say, to photo, and then you'll say select a photo, you can choose a photo, and I'm gonna put, for an example, this picture, and then you're gonna hit save. Make sure to save it. So when I'm here, let's say I wanna add it to my screen or whatever. So right now I need another slide of it, but you're just gonna press down on your screen. You're gonna go on the little plus button. It's gonna go down, and then it's gonna say Wedget Smith. You're gonna press on that, press the small one, so add Wedget, and then you're gonna press on the Wedget itself, and then Wedget, small number 3, press on that because you have other choices. Press on it, then I'm gonna put small number 5, which is the one I worked on, and then boom, there it is. So I'm just gonna move that, let's say, like to another slide. So then you have another little Wedget Smith, and that could just, you know, build up a theme within your phone and stuff like that. So that's how basically you add like the theme to your phone, by adding like those little pictures and stuff like that that make up with the app icons, which make your phone look super, super cute. So then I have this reminders wedget. I have this here just because, you know, when I wake up, I go on my phone because you don't have to turn off the alarm, and then I check some emails and stuff like that. But I do have this reminders thing, and I love that we're able to do this now because we just don't have to go on to the notes and stuff like that. But I put here a reminder, and it has 3 quotes, and it's titled God. First one says, I have heard your prayers and seen your tears, I will heal you. The second one is, pray, cry, repeat, but don't give up. And the third one is, there is nothing too big for God. So I just like keeping that there just so I have a reminder. So that was the same process as adding a Wedget Smith as well. You just press down on the screen, and then you go on the plus sign, and then it gives you the options of like adding whatever you want. So if you can see here, you'll have reminders, and so you go on and choose the size that you want, and it's basically the same process as adding the other Wedget Smiths of the pictures. So I'm basically going to show you now what I decided to put on my home screen, exactly like what specific apps I wanted there to be first, and how I split up like my sections and stuff like that, if that makes any sense. Here on the first page, I have my Wedget Smith, which is just the time. Then over to it, I have my camera, weather, photo, and Gmail apps, which I use every day, literally. Then I have my reminder, and then following that, I have the social apps that I use on a daily basis. So I have Snapchat, TikTok, YouTube, and Instagram. And then over to the right, I have like a cute little picture. I love cow print stuff, so I have my little cow print stuff there. And then obviously on the dock, I have my phone, messages, Safari / Google, whatever, and FaceTime call. So that's what's on my first screen. When we move on, so I added this cute little calendar, and then I added 2 other Wedget Smiths just to have like that cute vibe going on. I love that picture of Obama with that basketball. I think it's so dope. So I had to add that. I saw it on Pinterest. Literally, guys, also, I got all my like app icon stuff on Pinterest. Now I have the other apps that I do use frequently, but there are a lot, and I wanted to put them in like little groups. But here I have my TV folder. It's basically Netflix and Disney Plus. Okay, next is my finance folder. I have Cash App, Venmo, my bank mobile app, Discover, in my wallet. Then I have my music. I use Musi, Spotify, music, and a piano thing for my class, and TuneTrack. That's another thing that I'm trying to figure out. And then I have Apple. This folder is for all the Apple apps that I didn't want to delete off my phone entirely, so I just put them into a folder because you never know when you need them. Here I have my calculator, voice memo, watch, app store, Apple store, find my iPhone, translate files, settings, Safari, contacts, shortcuts, clock, and reminders. Next, I have my photos folder. Here I have Visco, Darkroom, Huji, Rad VHS, Photogrid, PicMonkey, Kunyi app. I think it's Kunyi app. Yeah, Kunyi app. So then I have my social folder, which is Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, Tumblr, Messages, WhatsApp, Jamify, Daily Horoscope, Shop, and an app distribution thing. Then here I have my Berkeley folder. This is basically just like things that I need for my school. So it's just a metronome, timetable, and notes. And then my last folder is the navigation folder, just stuff when I'm driving, like GPS, Google Maps, Uber, and the passport thing. Just to pay like meters around Boston. If I don't have like any quarters or whatever, I just use that app to pay with my card on the phone. So basically that is it with the apps that I have on my phone and how I just divided them into like folders and stuff like that. So yeah, that is basically what is on my phone. iOS 14 edition. Hopefully this video helps you guys get inspired or just find your aesthetic and the theme that you want for your phone. This update is pretty cool. But yeah, you guys, this is, oh, also this is my case. It's just like a neutral purple color that I love so much. So yes, you guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys found this helpful. I tried to keep it not too long so you guys are just like quick and easy about it. If you guys actually like are inspired by this video and do mess around with this update and make your own theme on your phone and stuff like that, please comment it down below. I would love to see pictures of it. I'll see you in my next video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, fam, I'll see you later.